The moment you think your family might be normal, someone starts crying for no reason and hides in a bush for 4 hours. Never is this madness more apparent than on Christmas Day. Tomorrow, most of us will spend Christmas with some assortment of humans that resemble family. They might not be your family. Perhaps they are strangers, and you've walked into their house at 2 p.m. asking where the prawns are at. Either way, you will most definitely recognize 8 very specific people. And this is what they look like. 1. The nosy auntie. This character has probably been cooking since 4:30 a.m., and hasn't slept in 5 weeks, so in fairness is probably delusio L. They want to know why you're not married yet. They want to know why you've put on weight. When you were younger they aggressively shouted, "What on earth have you been eating? Look at your skin." Any confidence you may have built over the year is crushed by this auntie at Christmas. She tells you what she really thinks, and goes to sleep standing up in the kitchen, fully clothed, at 9 p.m. 2. The train wreck cousin. If you can't quite identify the train wreck cousin, then you are the train wreck cousin. We all secretly love this family member, because they make all of us look immensely successful by comparison. They are lacking direction. Perhaps they've been in trouble with the law, they might dabble with the drugs, and their Facebook statuses are always the subject of many conversations. They probably tried to get out of seeing the family on Christmas Day, but their parents forced them. Someone, probably the nosy auntie, explicitly offends them by asking something like, "So, you've put your family through quite enough this year, haven't you?" Which we all know isn't actually a question. Train wreck cousin swears every year they are done with Christmas. 3. The prodigy. No young person likes them. They got an annoyingly high HSC result, or have a great career, or saved a stray dog, or volunteered in Africa for 3 years, or are just very sweet and loves a well-ironed floral dress and sensible shoes. Old people love the prodigy, as does the nosy auntie. Everyone secretly wishes the prodigy was their kid, except it's not a secret, because they keep saying *tear like, "Why aren't you more like Francis?" No one resents the prodigy more than the train wreck. For the sentimental old person. This is the person who becomes misty-eyed at about 4 p.m, after approximately 3.5 glasses of red wine. Seeing the family together just gives them all the feelings all at once. This is often a grandparent. They start thinking about the people who are no longer here to celebrate Christmas, expressing a sense of nostalgia which results in them grasping the young folk by both shoulders, telling them how proud they are, and how much they would have loved dear Uncle John. 5. The conservative uncle. This uncle isn't a fan of the refugees. He thinks political correctness has gone too far. Don't even get him started on the homosexuals. People tiptoe around him until around about 5 p.m, when they decide to just stir *tea because things are starting to get boring. They suggest we should just abandon border control and let all 40 million refugees in.